We are live. Welcome. We are playing some Savage Worlds here. These guys are
Technically.
they're in some sort of space station, and they have I'm joined by Rory, Ebo, and Lee, and they've awakened and have no memories. And
We're in a cafeteria.
they're in a cafeteria. They killed some totally not zombies and patrol bot. And
And found food and water.
you did find food and water, and it appears to be good.
Or at least edible.
And have cleaned up the viscera and gore that is splattered everywhere upon us.
I mean, kind of. You're still in zero G, so viscera and gore just kind of, it just goes everywhere in little clumps, and that's life, you know.
And didn't we just hear a noise?
So,
What? I've been hearing noise this whole time.
you guys are in a cafeteria. So just to show you the ship here, I'm gonna use Marcos. So, you guys started off in the military bridge, which was this weird winding set of tubes, and you found the outermost conjoining corridor. And did not kill yourselves with the airlock, and then eventually got over
I
to
considered it.
the residential bridge, where you guys aren't very far into the residential bridge. You just basically found the first cafeteria you found and started eating because you're all starving.
Yep.
The residential bridge is an observation deck, and there's a huge window on one side of it that while you guys are eating, you'll figure out pretty quickly as a lens, and it has some controls on it, so you can kind of zoom it in and out if you want. But right now it's focused on a swirling mass of like sort of like orange and yellow and white sort of colors.
It's just out in space somewhere.
Yeah, appears to be.
Does it look like a gas giant?
Something like that, yeah.
I don't even know what that means. Hold on. Let me check. I need to make sure. Yeah, he definitely doesn't know what that means.
Evo's character definitely knows what that means. So.
Evo's character
That's
is
not so
on
good.
XJ028 Larry. Or just Larry, as far as I'm
And
concerned.
things
The
have
question
kind
is,
of.
what does XJ028 stand for?
Things have kind of quieted down. And you guys have had your fill of like, water that tastes very sterile, and food that is kind of preservable and kind of bad.
Oh.
Oh, you do. There is a basically there is a microwave, and so you can find some food in there that you could heat up that might not be terrible.
I'm gonna basically eat everything.
We also had found a bathroom next to the cafeteria.
Yep.
That's where I had cleaned up as much as I could.
Yeah.
It's all right, when you come back out, you're gonna a big glob of viscera is
Okay,
gonna hit
that
you in
was a couple of
the
airlocks ago.
nose.
I mean, I was trying to be careful. It does not. I mean, like, it
I'm not
doesn't
cleaning the viscera off me.
propagate everywhere.
So, oh yeah, and on your way here, Rory had found a bunch of like computer screens that seemed to be on the fritz. There was some announcements going on over the speakers that were trying to encourage some sort of activity, and they seemed to be being interrupted by this weird old dude who was, you were getting glimpses or like little bits of him saying things. So you guys are
It
full.
all sounded like propaganda bullshit to me.
And you're no longer tired because you've been sleeping for like ever. Was anyone hurt?
Oh no, I don't think so.
No.
I think we
I don't
scattered
even know
them.
how that works.
The ship is pretty beat up, but luckily, Rory's character stopped me from
Ebo may
completing.
have shot a hole through the outer hull, or maybe he
That definitely
didn't.
maybe happened.
We don't know why Ebo's character has the weaponry and armor that he does, but we don't need to know everything.
I only have one weapon, and it's a melee weapon.
Hey, I only have one weapon also. It is also a melee weapon.
I can't help that I forgot how to be on a space station, if they ever told me.
Oh no, I'm sorry. I do also have 15 other weapons. They are these.
No fire, and don't shoot a hole.
Well, I have fragmentation and thermal grenades. I'm pretty sure I can solve that problem real quick.
One EMP grenade was used.
Yes, that's why I'm down to three.
And a four.
That's why I have 15 other weapons and not 16 other weapons.
Those are spells per day.
So what are you guys up to?
Is there like a bottle?
Yes.
A bottle?
I'll fill it full of water.
Yeah.
Well, that's smart.
Is there... Yeah,
there's some sort of like space age water containers.
I'll take one with me.
Hmm. This is something noteworthy, Jeff. Do the water containers seem space age to me?
Yeah.
Hmm. They don't seem like normal.
Nope.
Ah. I'll say these water bottles look normal to anyone else. Or to anyone.
What do you mean?
Well, they look futuristic to me.
Okay.
Doesn't that mean something? How long have we been asleep?
I don't know. I have not been able to figure out dates of any kind, as far as
I
know.
We need to find this old man and get him to talk.
I think we need to go to the communication center.
Where's that?
Jeff?
Jeff, is this map posted anywhere?
Larry's gonna nod.
You guys looked at the maps a bunch. I mean, Rory's character had them up on screens and stuff. Basically, you have four main bridges and then a really small command bridge, but it's military, residential, engineering, and storage.
So when you get to the command area.
Yeah, we do. Well, let's start, I don't know, chopping everything up that gets in the way.
How about we try to get there without having to chop anything up?
Well, we'll see how well that works when all the weird zombie people start coming at us again.
I guess.
Right. Or the death robot.
So are you guys going to start, I guess, where are you heading then?
South?
Okay, so you're heading towards that inner strut.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think the idea, that's not the right one.
Jeez.
Oops. Abort mission.
Let's,
like this way?
Sure.
Do I have to make myself smaller?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'll do it. I'm not happy.
I believe in you, Larry.
I did it. Hello.
There we go. I moved that all to the background. So, yeah, you guys are heading, like, towards that strut. That works.
And Larry's going to talk about how good his food was.
Do you want to bring some with us?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he's definitely. Got... Yeah. I have some in my pockets, too.
Hmm. Yeah, I did stuff two water bottles and some food into the bag with the hand grenades.
Yeah, one of those treaded robots will approach you guys while you're walking down a small hallway. This one does not have weapons.
Hmm.
It looks also like it's aside from the treads which are clearly magnetic, the rest of it is modeled a bit more like a human. It's not very well done, but it looks very androgynous and a little creepy, completely bald, and it'll approach you, and then it'll kind of bend and incline its head, and it will say, "Welcome, unconnecteds. Please follow me." And
where follow you
off.
Where
it'll stop and turn, it'll say to watch the video and reconnect. It'll
what,
turn
up.
No thanks. Can you take us to where the old man is?
It'll turn back to you and it will say, all you have to do is wait. Ha ha ha.
When I look around, I'm gonna say, I'm not gonna follow him.
We need to go to the command center. Can you take us there?
It's imperative. Very important. Top priority stuff.
Command center. Command center requires connection. This way, the robot will tread away.
Oh, we'll maybe do that once we get to the command center.
Take us to the command center, please. My mom always told me to say please.
The robot will turn around and tread back up to you and will say, your mother was indeed wise. We can go to the command center after you've connected. Connections are required.
Why?
Unfortunately, everyone in the command center is dead.
Why do we need to be connected if they're dead?
Who's going to enforce these rules?
Connection is required to operate, not... it'll kind of cock its head. Not required as an option, required as... It's just how it works.
Why is everybody zombies? Or whatever they are. The crazy people who attacked us. What's up with that?
Ha ha ha. Your joke is funny and understood by me.
What about the other robot? We blew it up.
Other?
Yeah, the one with the guns.
It like shrugs.
They taught you to shrug?
I've been taught many things.
Really? Who's the old man?
Command center?
The old man is waiting for you in the mirror.
What the hell does that mean? What? No, look, the
He's
old
in
man
a mirror,
in the...
You have to find the mirror.
Jeff, is there a computer terminal?
It's saying that...
There every once in a while is like... not a computer terminal, but like a power box in the wall type of thing.
With the screen?
Oh, there would be one. You guys, by this point, I assume, aren't just standing still. You can approach that inner strut, and there is a terminal with a screen there, yeah.
I'll, like, tap it to get it to go on?
Yeah, it'll turn on, though, after some static.
I'll wait for the old man?
Yeah.
This guy, take us to him.
I would very much like to do that. He is very far away. The mission must be completed in order to go to him.
What are the mission parameters?
The mission parameters are... Well, they are for those who are connected. Perhaps you would like to watch the video.
What does the process of connecting entail?
Oh, it's simple and painless.
Last time someone told me something was painless... Oh, I don't remember that, because it happened a long time ago, and then I was asleep forever, and now I don't remember anything.
Your joke is funny and understood by me.
You forgot your ha-ha-ha that time.
No. Timing is essential. Also, unexpected. Never mind. It's gonna tread off and motion for you to follow it.
Well, we can always not get connected. I'm gonna draw my sword and start following.
Who is the man in the video?
Okay, it'll stop and turn around. You guys can tell that it's not going to force you to go anywhere, but as long as you keep talking to it, it seems like it'll forever turn back around and find you again.
I like to think that it's walked 10 feet away and then come back like six
like
or seven
times now. Yeah.
It's like caller on the telephone where they aren't allowed to hang up as long as you keep trying to talk to them.
Yes.
Good. This thing. Wait, how long have you been here?
It will say, oh, that's Gustav.
Okay. What does Gustav do?
He's an astrophysicist.
Hmm.
As well as a scientist and a computer person. He has created incredible advances in science, especially areas involving intelligence.
Hmm. And what about... How long has this space station been here?
Space station?
Or whatever this is.
Oh, this ship.
Yes.
This is a weirdly shaped ship.
It will, think for a little bit, it looks like. And it'll say, quite a number of years.
Hmm. You're like a robot, right? Can you give me like an exact number of years?
32.
Sure.
32 what years?
Like, Light years?
Well, Ben here is, well, subjective. You see, the ship is very fast.
How long has it been since it launched from wherever it launched from?
Oh, 2 years.
Hmm.
Where did it launch from?
Earth.
And is that Earth years?
Yes.
What year is it now?
Planetary body outside.
Excuse me?
Look like gas giant.
Jupiter.
Oh, okay.
Why did he send a bunch of people up past Jupiter? Wait, where are we going?
I'm sorry, but the mission parameters are for those who are connected. This way.
We're going from Earth to Jupiter. Got it.
I'm going to follow it with my sword out.
It does not seem to care that you're armed.
That's fine.
Like, literally doesn't even seem to register. And it'll take you to what looks like a medical bay.
Is this in the residential section still?
You're still in the you're still in the outskirts. So, like, if you look at Marcos, you're going past an airlock, past another airlock, and down here. You haven't entered the middle of the residential area at all. The robot almost seems to be avoiding it. But it'll take you to this medical area where there are a number of cots there that are on the ground in a way that would make it seem like, you know, this ship is designed to at least function on a place that has gravity sometimes. There's a bunch of cabinets and lockers and stuff in there. And the robot will direct you past the cots towards a medium-sized dark room that has a projector hanging from the ceiling and pointing at a large screen. Right this way.
I'm going to say, wait, before we go in there. What you said the people in the command center were dead. How did they die?
We're not entirely certain.
We as in you and someone else.
Data.
Data is...
information.
Are there more than one of you robots?
Yes.
Are there other robots like you? Yes, okay, good. You don't know why the people in the command center... You don't know how they died. When did they die?
They died approximately... Sorry, Jeff is thinking. Approximately 3 hours ago.
So...
Were they killed?
Murder is suspected, yes.
By whom?
More than likely Gustav.
Why?
He said he was very far away from here.
Yes.
In other words, he's murdering people remotely?
Shrugs.
Efficient and cold, but...
Right this way.
Who's Gustav?
Will being connected put us at risk of being murdered?
An astrophysicist. We don't believe so.
Have you found other people who are connected? In the last 3 hours?
Some, yes.
Are they running around and being crazy and hitting things?
No.
You found other people like us? Who are willing to talk to you? Or capable of talking to you?
Yes, but they're connected.
Connected to what?
Newman.
Okay. What's that?
What did Bitumen?
Newman. Right this way.
Can you say that slower?
Newman.
Newman. Newman. So
one of the three I posted, I'm sure.
In the military area, there were a bunch of crazy people running around and attacking things. Are you aware of this?
They're dead. Those are not people.
Are there
a lot of those people?
They were murdered.
And now their corpses are running around?
We believe it's a strange chemical reaction. Or something like that. It shrugs again.
Did Gustav... Wait, you think Gustav did this on purpose?
I don't understand his intentions.
You're not a very good robot, then.
Gustav guy, and I'm gonna bash his brains in.
Good plan.
And then I'm gonna connect him.
And we're in space, so. Well, it adds up.
Righto.
Can we turn this thing around?
Once you have completed the mission.
What is the mission?
Oh,
the
God. Mission just gonna say, not only available to people who are connected. Yes, we're aware.
Exactly.
Perhaps, given the extreme circumstances, you can tell the mission parameters to someone who will be connected shortly.
Yeah, it pauses for a bit. This video will explain.
And it, well, the video
is these weird brainwashing videos?
No. The video specifically mentions that it is not brainwashing.
Last time something told me that.
The video.
Never mind. I was going to start a joke, but last time I made a joke, I was.
It happens to the best of us.
Displeased.
How do you get connected?
A wire. It will attach to your head behind your ear.
I'm going to reach behind my ear.
Do I have a cut there, Jeff?
Yeah, you can find that you have a little flap of skin there. When you touch underneath that flap of skin, you feel something that's metal, but it feels like rough and kind of gross. And when you look at your finger, it's all like black.
Is this supposed to happen? I'll throw it to the robot.
No, that should be sent in for maintenance.
It's attached to me. Can we remove it? I'm gonna look at the sword.
There's a maintenance device over here. Perhaps you'd like to watch the video and begin the process.
The not brainwashing video.
Yes. What are the long-term effects of this not being maintained?
The video explains, but basically, killing each other.
Hmm.
What? If we don't get this maintained, we'll kill each other?
Yes, it is known.
Is that what those not living things are doing?
Maybe. We hadn't recorded that. Updating data.
Okay. I'm gonna go watch this video. If I don't like what I see, I'm gonna leave.
I'm gonna stay out here, and you can watch the video. And if you're not brainwashed, then you can tell us that.
Sure.
Lee, are you gonna go watch the video?
I am gonna go watch the video.
Okay. It is just
supposed to be a good video.
I mean, probably, yeah.
Yes.
It's better than sitting around here talking to this stupid robot.
It is one of the best videos. It's meant for the future of mankind.
I can watch the video. The video is playable again in the future, right?
Okay, you convinced me. I'll watch it.
Yes, and I'm not even going to shut the door if you wish to stand outside.
Okay, I'll stand out in the direct line on the side of the door, so I can't see inside.
Okay. He's definitely not paranoid. Yeah, the robot will start video.
Before I walk in, I'll say, your paranoia is well-founded, but no one's learning anything standing out here talking to this dumb robot.
Sure, you tell me if you're brainwashed in a few minutes.
I will absolutely tell you if I'm brainwashed.
Alright. Alright. Yeah, it'll start a video. You will see there's a video with no sound on it. And there's a narrator talking over it. And in the video, you see that there are people loading tanks and firing guns, and there's explosions and smoke. And then you hear the narrator say, "The 80s were a rough time in human history." You see nuclear bombs going off in huge cities. Despite endless diplomacy, our differences were just too great. And then a question mark appears on the screen. What was the human race to do? And then a cartoon computer drops from the sky. Enter Newman, synthetic superintelligence created by Gustav Damera. And then you see videos of cartoon people placing computer chips in their head and smiling. When Newman connected with people, the most wonderful thing happened. We started to understand one another. Words pop up in a thought bubble above Newman's head, and it says, "Compassion wins the day and war goes away. We understand some people experience anxiety about reconnecting. Are you afraid you'll lose who you are, lose control, or have your mind tampered with?" The cartoon Newman shrugs while smiling. "No need to worry about it. Newman has a perfect record. Not a single connected individual has ever claimed any of those things have happened to them. We hope you've enjoyed this presentation and are ready to avoid the perils of war and hate by simply reconnecting. And then the video stops. And then the robot says, right this way to maintenance.
Is maintenance part of reconnecting, or can I get maintained without reconnecting?
It is the first step.
Larry's going to sit there staring at it, kind of hunched over, with his face kind of planted against the screen, and he's going to look at the robot and he's going to go, play it again.
Certainly, the robot will play it again.
Okay.
Are you brainwashed?
He'll get up, he'll look satisfied, and he'll go, I get it.
Smoke.
Hmm?
Are you brainwashed?
No, but I am interested in getting maintained without connecting.
You don't want to be connected?
No, absolutely not. That sounds fucking terrible.
Okay, I'll watch the video then.
Okay, yeah, the video will play a second time. And you guys
a third time.
A third time, sure.
Yeah, I don't think we should get connected.
No,
what is option B?
Option B, to me, is get maintained and do not get connected.
Option B is a plan that leads to war and destruction.
Mm. Okay. What is it?
If you remain unconnected, your human nature will take over and cause you to not understand those around you, and it will breed war and destruction. You and your kin will certainly suffer. Option B is not an option.
Oh, no, option B is pretty much the best option at this point, because I kind of like who I am now, even though I don't remember most of it. And I still would rather have what I have now than whatever Newman would get.
Do any of the three of you have a skill that you would like to roll to trick this robot with logic?
Hold on.
Are you kidding?
How about persuasion?
You can roll persuasion at a -2.
The least combat-oriented skill I have is possibly piloting, but at the same time, it was probably for combat.
I have healing, but that's only so I can identify my own injuries.
And that's right, there is actually a computer skill that I did not find the first time around, so I can do nothing with computers.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I've been letting your engineering kind of work when you're able to, like, get your hands dirty with wires and shit.
It wasn't engineering, it was knowledge science.
Knowledge science. Yeah, we're playing this a little fast and loose. But you can roll your persuasion -2 if you'd like. You also get your wild die, but the -2 does apply to the wild die.
I'll be honest, I only have one way of interacting with computers, and it's called an EMP grenade.
You don't add the dice together though, right?
You don't, so the wild die, you would need to roll a 6 in order for it to succeed.
Hmm.
Oh, okay. So it's a -2. So you would roll your persuasion -2 and your wild die -2.
Hey, that explodes.
It does.
Boom. Oh,
so
no.
I got a 3 on the base roll.
All right.
And I got a 1 on the wild die.
So
I think on the base roll, you actually got a 1.
The No, you don't get the -2 for the exploding die. He just hits space up.
Okay.
Now optionally, if you want, the base success difficulty is 4. You could spend a Benny if you care to. You don't have to, obviously.
What does that do?
Nope.
It offers a bonus, so Jeff knows what it does.
Of course he does.
I agree.
Yeah, I did not remember that there was, I did not find a computer skill when I was making this character, and I did not find an engineering skill because I was kind of not paying attention, I guess, to skills. So, I am really bad at those.
Every player starts the game with 3 bennies.
You can
use a Benny to reroll a trait test.
Mm.
And you can use a Benny to soak damage, is what it looks like.
Mm. Narp.
Anyway,
Moving on.
There is. You guys are spending a lot of time talking with this robot, so this.
Yes, we are.
Since we're a little unfamiliar with the rules, being all of us.
Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-
So for what it's mattering, I'm still not finding an engineering skill in the
I am talking to the robot.
So if the other two players want to also be talking to the robot, and you know, you're obviously going towards the same goal, you can also roll persuasion.
I'm trying to disrupt the robot accidentally by talking to it about stupid things.
Jeffrey, D4 minus 2.
Are you sure there's like an engineering skill?
Nope.
It's going to be a D4 minus 4 for me. I'm not going to roll it.
It does explode. If that matters to you.
I'm not intentionally trying to trick it. I'm just a chatty Cathy.
Okay, that's a negative one. 1d6 exploding minus 2 is 3. All right, I'm done.
So in the event that one of you had gotten a success, it would have given Rory's roll a plus 1. That's how helping works in this game. Yes.
Nope.
All right. The robot seems unconvinced, and it'll show you where to reconnect, and that's about all it's going to do. It'll show you where maintenance is to start that process.
All right, well, maintenance is good. I don't like this black stuff. So I'm going to go get maintenance done, and then you guys can tell me if I'm brainwashed. And if I am, that'll punch me until I'm not or something.
Are you going to go get maintenance?
Yes.
All right. Yeah, there's a chair there that you can sit down in.
All right.
There's a device that will really not gently grab onto your head and hold your head in place, like, so you literally cannot move. Anyone's watching, you'll see like a flashlight, looking at the back of his head. Some little metal grabbers will like peel that part of the skin back, look at it. It sticks a really large needle in there, and you hear like the thing kind of actuating but not moving, and there's like it tries a few times. This fucking hurts, Lee.
I'm gonna like flail around.
Yeah, your head can't move. There's some emergency releases on the thing.
Well, I'm just good. I'm gonna give it a moment.
It's just saying error, and it keeps poking you in the brain. Sword. Yeah, you can hit the release and get out of there.
Excellent. And then I'm going to hit the machine with a sword.
Wait! Don't do that part.
I'll stop.
Okay.
Is there,
I'll
like,
do it.
An interface or a screen, Jeff? Anything to interact with the device?
There's a screen in that room.
I'll say, am I bleeding? God damn it, I feel like I'm bleeding.
They're probably bleeding. Have Larry look at it.
Hey, robot, do you have any towels? Can you give me a towel?
Jeff, is it the same stupid screen of repeating messages?
No, this screen, it looks like a diagnostic screen. There's errors on it. Basically, it looks clearly like this program does not know what's wrong with this character or Smoke. And it also looks like it has queued a task for Smoke to be disposed of.
Hmm. Is it broken?
Doesn't appear to be.
Can I change it? What it's trying to do?
Sure. What are you trying to change it to?
To safely remove the corroded piece of metal.
Oh, you can mess around with the computer. It looks like it does not do that sort of surgery.
What does it do?
I mean, it looks like it's like built for routine maintenance, and that it's finding errors at a level that it cannot repair. Like whatever is in his head is really far gone, really fucked up. You can like find the little X that you can like click to get rid of him being scheduled for elimination if that's what you want.
Okay, Smoke, I've got you covered.
Okay.
You're not scheduled for termination anymore.
Wait, what? How is the termination supposed to be carried out? They're gonna send more robots. I have plenty.
Is that long needle?
You would once you hit the X, you'll see that there are some like tubes that it was like sort of moving over to the chair with like hypodermic needles and stuff, and then it starts moving them back into storage.
So yeah, it's gonna kill you.
Great. I'm glad that Newman is so understanding of people whose weird head things aren't working right.
He does seem like he's trying to help us out.
No, that's definitely not true.
Well, that's what it said in the video.
Well, okay. Here's how I see it. I think the video was mostly lies.
His eyes are getting wide.
Okay, you're gonna have to bear with me. I know science fiction when I see it. That whole thing is shenanigans founded by Gustav, who just wants us to believe that there's some sort of robot that's leading us to a better world. It's definitely not. Gustav is the robot. He's the AI guy behind this thing. And he's like a crazy person who wants us to kill each other or something. I don't know. I mean, what we need to do is turn the ship around and chop his fucking head off.
He's going to start rubbing his head.
Hey, Jeff, I cannot find a computer skill or an engineering skill, just so you know.
Yep, like, shenanigans.
I don't think they exist.
Rory, we can use your science skill for that because it would make the game work a lot better. Is that fine with you?
Yeah, no, it looks like knowledge is a general, and then you specialize in an area, and you're supposed to get a bonus if it's in your area, is what it says.
Let's use your science skill. I really want to just do that. That's okay. There's...
because there might be like a knowledge engineering that I, instead of science is what I was supposed to have, a knowledge computer that I was supposed to have instead of knowledge science.
They talk just
a base skill.
This is something I maybe should have looked up. But
they talk about a knowledge computers in the hacker in the future one.
Right. So it'd be under. Okay. So what knowledge? If you have the knowledge skill, you can make any knowledge roll, and you get a. You're supposed to get a bonus in any of these specialties that you have for it, basically.
Oh.
So if it's a knowledge computer roll, I should be able to make a knowledge roll on it, and then I wouldn't get the bonus because it's I have science.
Oh. Okay, we're not even cheating then. Let's do it exactly like that.
This episode is called Fast and Loose.
Yes.
I agree.
All right. So, are you guys doing anything else in the little medical wing there?
Yep.
What's up?
I'm going to go to the robot and I'm going to say, hey, where are there more robots? And will they get pissed off if I cut your head off?
Robots do not get pissed off.
All right, I'm going to cut his head off.
Okay.
Good. I mean, at least I feel better.
The robot keeps moving around, like...
But the head doesn't talk, right?
It looks like maybe some sort of sensor was in its head. Like, it keeps moving around kind of like Roomba patterns. Like, it's trying to feel out the train, but it doesn't say anything.
I'm going to take its head.
Okay, you can take it.
All right,
And hand it to it.
I mean, it looks like it's a very confused robot for a very long time, right? It doesn't drop the head, but yeah.
Well, I'm going to say, you know, that might not have helped, but I feel a lot better.
Hey, Jeff, does this computer have, like, an access panel or anything like that? This robot.
The robot that you chopped its head off?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, it does. It's in the treads.
Okay. Can you, like, hold it still?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
I'm going to try to rewire this robot.
Okay. I don't know what good it's gonna do without a head, but I appreciate your moxie.
Okay. Yep. I mean, you can get the panel open. There are like blinking red lights, like the whole system's fucking failing. What are you gonna try to do, Rory?
Can I make a repair check on the robot?
You can. What are you trying to do?
I'm gonna put the head back on.
Oh. You would know. You have the repair skill, I think, right?
I do. I do have repair.
You would know that you're going to need some sort of tools for that, but there are a bunch of cabinets and lockers around here.
Okay. I have a shovel.
In the cabinets and lockers, if you guys look, they're not locked. There's actually a bunch of medical supplies, including some like first aid kits and some like space age spray-on type stuff, as well as other normal like salves and whatnot. And yes, you do find that there is a locker that has a bunch of tools and stuff in it.
Okay, I will try to, I don't know, reconnect the wires and...
Hey, maybe you can find a better weapon than the shovel.
Duct tape the head back on or something. use athletic tape to put the head back on?
I mean, it looks like it's going to take a while, but yeah, nothing's stopping you unless those two are.
Sit down and pull a candy bar out of my bag and start chewing.
That chair over there and see what happens again.
Nope. That's fine.
You can make a repair roll, Rory.
Okay. So, Jeff, what is the easiest way to do this? For the semaphore?
The easiest, you could hit You could hit shift enter and put the D6 with the same modifier on the second line, I suppose. Otherwise, you could just roll them both. That works. So you succeed. I mean, it takes maybe a half hour to get it kind of working. If you wanted it to be relatively durable, you could spend another 20 minutes on it.
No.
Okay. Yeah, the robot will come back online. Are you trying to do anything else with it while you're working?
Yeah, I wanted to try to repair it into thinking that we were connected or something like that. Like, so that it can't tell the difference.
Yeah, you can try and cross a wire that'll do that, and it'll come back online, and it'll look at the three of you, and it'll say, "Great success," and then it'll look at Smoke, and it'll say, "Was that really necessary?"
No, but I feel a lot better.
I'm glad.
Can you take us to the command center now?
Right this way. It'll start taking you to the inner strut there. It'll go ahead.
He's just gonna ask if Smoke was connected now.
Yes.
Yep. I mean, more or less. I don't know.
But of course, you don't need to ask that. Your joke is understood and appreciated.
Thank you. Yours is too.
Unbeknownst to anybody, Larry makes the best pretend robot.
Oh god. So the robot, using Marcos again, is gonna open up. You can see that the inner airlock is actually like locked, like in a lock that you would have had to pick or something or hack. But the robot will lead you in there, and then into another big tube. The inner tubes here have shitloads of windows. Not on the sides, because that would just look at the spaceship, but on the ceiling and the floor. And you can look out into space. You do get a much better picture of your environment. The observation deck, none of you guys messed with the panel, but it looks like it was probably on full zoom. You can see that you are quite a distance from a ways away from a planet, which is Jupiter. It's a massive planet, but you are a long ways away from it. So like it looks big, but at the same time, there's a lot of distance there. You can see that you appear to be in orbit around a moon that's mostly, it appears to be like white and blue with a bunch of brown.
Robot. Robot.
What?
What moon is that?
That is Europa.
Okay. Why are we around Europa?
Mission details are found at the command center for those who are connected.
Well, that's us.
But you'll tell us at the command center?
Yes.
Good.
Okay. Jeff, is the spaceship spinning?
Slowly, yeah.
What's its axis? Or its spin points, I guess.
Oh, the command center would be the central point. I mean, these things are very slow moving, Rory, but with your knowledge skill, you could probably tell that it's synchronized with the moon.
Okay, so we're in a stable orbit, or yeah, at least as much as I can eyeball that.
I mean, appears to be, like, you've actually seen, like, a really awful zoomed-in image of this moon at the end of the last session, but, like, you're pretty sure, at least in the last hour, you probably aren't seeing a different part of the moon.
So we were saying stable over a fixed point?
Yeah.
What, the spaceship itself, does it seem to be having any pitch or yaw?
I mean, I'm trying to think here. It would be, No, it would just be rotating, lined up with the moon's rotation, basically.
But so like
a very slight rotation, but mostly just an orbit.
Okay, so I mean, like at one point, will the military section be pointed out, and another point, a different one of the sensors pointed at the moon?
No. That's what you're asking. No, it looks like the engineering section is always pointed directly at it.
Okay. Interesting. Okay.
The robot's going to take you guys to the command center, and when you guys get into there, it's it smells just terrible in there. There are bodies pretty much everywhere, or at least what's left of them.
Hmm. Well, I knew it. The robot's trying to kill us.
It looks like a nightmare scene. Like there's a couple levels to this place, and it looks like the people basically tried to kill and eat each other, and they all appear to be dead. Pieces of bodies just like strewn all over. There's blood just like floating everywhere. Bodies just floating everywhere. Some of them like snagged on things, pieces of equipment. There's like screens and keyboards and stuff basically all over the place. A lot of the screens are cracked or damaged, and you can, you know, see like a flickering of lights and like you hear buzzing every once in a while, that type of stuff. It's just kind of a dark command center.
Does it look like there's any part of it where there was somebody in charge?
I mean, it looks like there is like a main bridge sort of section of it.
Is there a light switch?
It's above you. What, Eva?
Is there a light switch?
The lights or anything? The lights are on, yeah.
Oh, they're just dark? I thought it was kind of dark.
The lights are... Sorry, the lights are on. It is a little dark. The screens are flickering quite a bit. There's a slider if you wanted to increase the intensity of the lights.
Yep, I will do that.
All right. Yeah, it kind of stabilizes a bit. Lee, it looks like the main command is above you, but you are at 0G.
Yeah, I'm just going to, I don't know, float on up there.
Yeah, you can push off the ground and float on up there. You can see that there's people wearing what look like military uniforms, a few people that look like they're dressed more casually, but their bodies are just floating around there. You could see one guy who looks like pretty much like he probably wears a hat a lot of the time, and you see like a military major sort of hat floating about, but he is dead. It looks like a big chunk of his side was bitten and torn off, probably with human teeth.
Neat.
Does he have a card or a lanyard or
any of them? He has an access card.
I'll take that from him.
Sure.
That's smart. So,
so robot.
The robot did not jump up there. The robot is magnetically treaded to the ground.
I'll say it loudly.
Alright, the robot will say, "Yes, we have arrived. Congratulations."
What are the mission parameters?
The mission parameters can be found in that terminal.
Which one?
The one you're standing, well, floating next to.
You're a shiesty robot. You said you'd tell us when we got here. You don't know the mission parameters, do you?
You're right.
You see what I mean? Shiesty. You can't even trust a robot these days.
Hey, robot. What is the life support situation?
Excuse me?
This is a lot of junk in the atmosphere at this point in here. Can the life support handle this amount of stuff?
Or,
I would encourage you not to breathe in body parts of other individuals.
Yeah, but like the ventilation system, won't they get clogged up?
That's a good point. Data is noted.
Do you have somebody who you can put on that to clean it right now?
we are not equipped to clean up after massive amounts of death.
That seems like an oversight.
Can you clean up after small amounts of death?
Yes.
Okay, so why don't we start with that, and eventually it will go to a massive point, right?
The robot
enough small cleaning
nods.
Massive clean.
You hear the tape around its neck stretches a bit when it nods, and then it treads away.
Good.
Good enough.
I think
I
told it to clean the place up.
I'm still concerned about the we that it says. I realize that it's talking about this Newman thing, and then Newman probably wants to kill us, but...
No, Newman probably wants us to join with it again. And doesn't care if we die.
It's basically killing. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, anyway.
Well, does this terminal work?
Are you going to try the card?
Yeah.
Yeah, the card opens up. The terminal has a bunch of information, some really detailed maps. It looks like there were massive amounts of deaths in the residential area that were recorded before the system went down. The engineering and storage bridges seem actually to be more or less fine. Like, the two that you guys have been in seem to be the worst, because they have the most people in them. There are some logs, something about a massive electrical surge, maybe some sort of virus. The system's not sure what happened. You can find the mission seems to be to... there's a... in the engineering section, which is the one that is closest to the moon, there's a massive drill. And the mission parameters are to drill underneath the surface of the moon and grab a bunch of samples in huge capsules. Rory, it looks like, hacking be damned, this ship will not go back to Earth until that mission is completed. Like, it looks like really, like, top-level stuff.
I don't like that.
Well,
so we're stuck here.
Jeff, does it have like a crew log?
You can find that this was meant to be completed with a crew of 12, and they are all dead.
But we've seen more than 12 people already, right?
Oh, there are hundreds of people aboard this ship, Rory. Sorry.
Right. What, like the manifest? I'm just gonna try to. Look at see how many people are listed on the manifest, roughly.
There are hundreds of people. It's identified like a group of about 6 that are maybe still alive, but it has flagged them as not people who are likely to complete the mission.
Are we listed?
You're listed as dead.
But we have personnel files.
Uh-huh. Ebo and Lee are listed with personnel files as military operatives. Rory, you're listed as special military operative.
What's Larry's name?
We'll, go ahead, Ebo.
His name is actually, what was it? XJ028?
There you go.
That's the actual name.
There are pictures that go with these, so you can look up some basic details about yourselves.
Okay.
It's so, also probably on his uniform, if this is his actual uniform.
What is Smoke's name?
Smoke's actual name is Philip. I don't have a last name for him.
Jeff, is Fritz listed?
No.
Interesting. Oh, wait, sorry, what was I? I was not military, what was I?
Special military.
You want me to finish it?
Okay. Interesting.
Thank you.
Fritz is probably born out of dead bodies like fruit flies are or whatever. I don't know.
Okay, Larry.
Hey, wait, can you use this thing to tell us how many more of those murder
Larry
robots
does
are
not
around?
Know who Fritz is.
Can you use this thing to tell us how many of those murder robots are around?
Yeah, well, what's the thing say about robots?
Operating normally.
How many?
There's one per wing.
Okay. So probably three left. For military
robots. I don't like that.
Hey Jeff, can I alter crew files here?
Probably.
I'm gonna tell this computer that Larry's alive.
That's smart, but I don't know why.
Okay.
I'll see if that works, basically.
I'll
change his entry to alive instead of dead.
Yeah, but you can. I mean, you have a very good override access right now.
Oh, okay.
Not
Does
bad.
It know where the six that are alive are?
They're in the storage wing. Yep. If you look at their positions, it looks like they're maybe holed up.
Think we should go and find them?
We might want to get this thing a little bit more stable. Are there, like, controls to make sure life support is still working and stuff like that?
Yeah, it looks like the ship's systems are actually fairly functioning well. The ship seems to believe that it was, you know, just a little over 2 years travel to get here in cryo. And, you know, with those calculations, you maybe have a couple of weeks to complete the mission at most before you start running out of air, is what it looks like.
And then we'd have to get back into cryo to head back.
Yes. Yeah.
Is there anything in there to explain why we lost our memories?
No, not really.
So it's unintentional.
Virus? Or something like that, was this right?
Like that, yeah.
Does it say anything about Gustav?
Are you gonna dig, Rory?
Sure.
You could make your science check. Yeah, I mean, you can still continue to pull up, like, little bits of the video here and there. But, it looks like, whatever the system is actively stopping it.
Okay.
Since you're logged in, basically, as the major, you'll get messages that are saying, you know, things like, we've arrived at destination. Orbit is successfully synchronized. Please launch the drill as soon as possible. Mission is paramount. Stuff like that.
Okay. I make sure I'll let all of this know to Larry and Smoke that, the situation with Aaron. Cryo sleep and getting mission done to return.
Launch the drill.
Is it automated, Jeff?
Doesn't look like it, but it's in the engineering wing.
Are there any robots that can do it?
There was air for hundreds of people for a couple of weeks, right? Mm-hmm. So for like six, there's air for a lot longer.
Nine. I mean, we don't know how many holes we punched in the hull.
Three, more like.
Why is there a military wing of this fucking place?
Because we're military.
Hey, Jeff, I'm going to look up Newman.
Okay.
I want to look up Newman.
I want to be special military.
You have to roll. There's no, like, information about Newman, but it looks like Newman is, like, some sort of core system, something everything's connected to.
Okay.
Are the remaining six people connected to Newman?
They're listed as connected, yes.
Larry's listed as connected also, right?
No. Larry's listed as alive, unconnected.
Okay. Can I change that to connected?
Yeah, you can. You can change it to connected, and then like half a second later, it changes back to unconnected.
Oh, so they're monitoring that.
Or whatever.
I think we should go talk to these possible survivors.
Okay. I mean, it can't be any worse than talking to that robot. Although they might be like robots also.
Yeah. Rory, you can also access video if you're interested. If you're looking for the survivors.
I want to see if I can find the survivors.
Yeah, they're holed up in a storage wing. They're not talking much. They look to be eating right now. There are what look to be five soldiers, as well as one soldier who's like absurdly chromed up. They're toting some pretty big guns. They look like they're pretty on edge.
So they look kind of like Larry?
Yeah.
Is there like a intercom to where they are? Do you guys want me to talk to them?
Yeah. Talking to them in person seems like a terrible idea now that I look at them.
Jeff, do I have their names from files?
Sure. we'll call one of them Roland.
Roland.
That's the sidebar.
I'm gonna try to activate the intercom.
Yeah, you can do that. Rory, once you activate it, even before you speak, you'll see a little ticker will go along the bottom of the screen that'll say, analog communication is discouraged. Please use a verified connection.
Roland.
The guy'll look up and he kind of like has kind of a what the fuck sort of look on his face as he looks at his buddies and he gives some signals. And they stand at attention. You hear some guns cocking.
We don't mean any harm to you. Don't worry.
He doesn't respond right away. Eventually, he'll go up and he'll press a button on the intercom and he'll say 6325. And he'll use the button.
Hey, Jeff, I'm going to do a query in the computer for 6325.
Oh, yeah, it appears to be in this region, his comm address.
So we'd be able to talk to him via Newman if we had that thing?
Jeff? Is that right?
Sounds correct, yeah.
What if we tell him our...
Roland, direct connection has been compromised. Analog connection preferred at this time.
I'm gonna give you like a thumbs up.
Sure.
Do you have lie?
There's persuasion.
I bet they use persuasion for everything.
Hey, Hen.
Okay. Yeah, Roland will push the button again. You can see he's given a dubious look to his comrades. He'll say, compromised how?
Mission classified.
Yeah, he looks again to his buddies. And then he'll push the button again. He'll say, what's the status of the mission?
Please give full report of status of surviving crew members at your station.
Push the button again. None.
Jeff, there's six of them?
I think he meant the other.
Please give status report on surviving military crew members at location.
Push the button. It's just us here. Who is this?
Jeff, what's the name on the card? Of the commander?
for the major, we'll call him
Antonio. We'll
call him, Major Mitchell.
This is Major Mitchell.
You can pass your. Is there a deception sort of skill?
I don't know.
There has to be. There's no way there isn't.
If there is a deception skill, I don't have it.
Wow, okay. We'll go with persuasion.
It's a really short skill list.
It is.
They have intimidation.
They have intimidation, but not lying?
Persuasion is fine.
What?
they have taunt.
Why is this not... Whatever.
Okay, 5.
Sure. Yeah, he'll, are you compromised, sir?
No, we're fine.
Not at this time, but Command Center has suffered severe damage.
I'm going to say ask them if they require assistance.
I'm not going to let that go through, Jeff.
Sure.
Please give me a report of current events.
All right. He'll say there was a weird sort of shock thing. We woke up. Most of the people were dead. Some of the people went haywire.
That sounds horrible.
Rory, you see him raise his eyebrows and looks to the rest of the crew members. One of them just shakes his head.
And then, can we get audio on them?
They're not speaking. And the other one like puts his hand up behind his ear. He looks real concerned. And then one of them shoots the intercom and it goes offline.
So they're talking to Newman, it looks like.
And Newman probably told them that the major is dead.
Probably. Hey Jeff, I saw the video, right?
You do, yeah.
What are they doing?
They look at each other for a bit.
Can I lock them in?
You can, yeah.
I'm gonna lock that door.
You can lock them in the storage area. They seem to also be kind of barricading the door.
Yeah, I don't want them coming here since I just told them where we're at, basically.
Can you get us that Newman information? Like, so that we can listen to Newman stuff? Over, like, yeah. A handheld sort of thing? I don't know.
That.
It looks like it requires very specific hardware that interfaces to a brain.
I am extra super glad I'm not connected to this thing.
Yeah.
Also that I apparently can't be connected to it for some stupid reason.
Did you think maybe we should go help them?
No, I think they're going to be fine.
I think they're connected to Newman, and if they see we're unconnected, they will either kill us or try to reconnect us.
Then we should kill them.
If they're willing to lock themselves in there, we should try to complete this mission without them. And then maybe they'll run out of air and die without us doing anything.
How fine-tuned is the life support control, Jeff?
not very important.
Okay.
Damn. I was hoping shit could get real dark.
I could just reduce the oxygen level by 50%.
All of a sudden, we're the demon from Event Horizon.
No.
What are you guys up to?
Wait, Rory, what did you say? What is your character's name?
He said call him Nick.
Nick.
What it matters, he looks like a young Indian man.
I'm gonna say, okay, Nick, let's go to this engineering place and see if you can figure anything out. Maybe we can reduce a 12-man team to 2 or 3.
Sounds plausible.
Is there any way you can, you know what? There probably isn't. So let's just go.
Jeff, Larry is still listed as alive, right? At this point?
Uh-huh.
Can I give him, like, full access to everything?
It looks like there is some access that requires, like, physical presence. Like, you could give him the key card.
Like, I mean, like, in the computer, can he be listed as having full access?
It doesn't look like there's a whole lot of access levels listed in the computer, but you can give him what you can, yeah.
Yeah, I'll give him, like, the highest that is possible listed. And then I'll wait a few seconds to make sure it actually sticks and not gets deleted.
Yeah, it does.
Okay. Hey, Smoke, you want to be alive again?
I'm actually not sure. How about no?
Right? For what it matters, I'm not going to list this alive again either.
Sure.
Let's go on.
I like the way you just signed Larry up for it without asking him.
Are you going this way, Roy?
Yes. I don't want to go.
I'm not sure Larry knows what alive means or.
I'm going to get a drink real quick. I'll be right back.
Pay attention.
If you told him about it and asked him if he was paying attention, he'd say, "Oh yeah, I was paying attention." But that's all you'd get out of him.
Larry's gonna look to Smoke, and he's like, "I want to be special military."
Well, as far as I'm concerned, Larry, you are special military.
Thank you. Maybe that's what this mission is for.
What they're doing is they're breeding super soldiers by putting them in ridiculous situations. I mean, and I'm not saying that's the plot to a video game I played one time, but it seems plausible.
Oh, I'm a super soldier already.
I can tell.
Did you watch these LCS games today?
No,
I worked, so I didn't get to watch shit.
They're good.
Yeah, I read the CLG one.
Yep, those games are pretty good.
I heard that one person described it as a total shit show. That's a yes.
It was, it was pretty interesting. They're both not great at some things. And, man, they got tilted pretty hard, I think, in the last game.
Someone said that that the last game was decided because it was basically a 6v5 with the Elder Dragon beating on Team Liquid. And then they said that Xmithy and Huhi landed perfect ultimates and the game was over.
They did. Huhi got stunned by a Sona ult, but he had threw down his Victor stun, on top of the three people that were standing next to Sona, including Sona. So he was stunned, and they were stunned. And then he ulted, and there was a lot of damage done by the other two while Fabi got zoned.
Mm-hmm.
I also recommend the second and third game. They're really good. Third game was pretty boss. CLG versus Team Liquid.
Alright. So you guys can continue on and enter the engineering wing.
Yeah, great. This game can't go any worse, probably.
No. The engineering wing is a lot more wide open. Mostly because in the middle of it, there is a massive, absolutely huge drill. It is kind of like if you've ever seen like those little hand drills for ice fishing. It looks kind of like that, except much, much larger. And then coming out of it in places are these various apparatuses and harnesses and other like sort of metal workings. And there's a ton of what look to be like canisters and tanks. seem to be attached to it with these tubes and stuff like that.
How long does the drill look like it's going to be?
The drill looks like, you know, it's a few stories, so like, could be upwards of 40, 50 feet.
So it looks like we have to get that close?
No. The drill is, basically like the base has all that shit that I just described, and the drill goes way above it. It looks like you'll have to, connect the drill to the surface.
What? Is there any way to lie to this thing and tell it that the machine's completed?
Convince it that it finished drilling?
Mm-hmm. Because there's no way we're operating this thing. We don't even know what we're supposed to be collecting.
Jeff.
Yeah.
This is a dumb question, but I do have driving and piloting at very minimal. Do I know how to drive and or pilot the drill? Or is that something different?
Yeah, you got the idea of the basics.
I can do it.
And Jeff, is the drill like a vehicle basically and it's going to go down and come back?
There is one chair on it. You do see that there is not necessarily an airlock, but there is an area in the floor underneath the drill that it looks like it would open up into space. There are not 12, I guess it would probably realistically be more like 15 little pods in the walls that have spacesuits. And there's a massive coil of like steel rope or wire that's attached to the drill.
So you like drop the drill and wind it back up?
Yep, it looks like it's supposed to be lowered down.
Like hundreds of kilometers.
Long way, yep.
Ah. Well, Larry, you can drive this?
Yep, that's probably how I'm supposed to get special military like you.
I think Fritz is what makes me special military.
He'll just shrug. I don't know.
I don't even know what to tell you about that fucking thing. It freaks me out, and it makes me a little nervous to sleep around you.
I don't think you've slept around me.
Yeah, there's a reason for that.
You also see that there is a side
room. Also, I'm not very tired.
The side room has this huge circular pedestal that has like a similar pedestal on top. And there are three different places in that side room that looks like would fit three of the canisters that are on the drill.
Okay. Here are some things I'm curious about. You might be able to help us out with, Nick. What are they supposed to have been grabbing off of this moon? Why did they need so many military personnel in the first place? Is there a way to trick it into thinking that we already did this stupid thing?
So, Jeff, what do the canisters of that hold?
The canisters are maybe the size of like a human-sized coffin. They look like they can seal airtight. They're definitely waterproof.
Do I think that this is for extracting water from under the surface of Europa?
Quite possibly.
This might be checking for water under Europa's surface then.
Okay, well, question number two. Why do they need so many military personnel here?
I thought we were drilling under the moon.
Yes.
Europa is the moon.
That doesn't look like the moon.
I mean, you're just really close to it. Jupiter is way bigger, and I'll point at Jupiter.
I mean, Jeff, we can definitely see Jupiter, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You can.
You see, think of Jupiter like Earth, and Europa is like the moon to Jupiter. Jupiter's way bigger than Earth. You know what? Don't think about it, man.
But this isn't the moon.
No, it's a different moon. There's only one, the moon.
Why did they name the moon twice?
I don't know. People make dumb decisions.
Scientists are stupid.
Yeah. Well, one day they'll give us back Pluto.
What y'all doing?
No. Can I drop the drill?
I think if we're gonna do that, we might want to get spacesuits on first, since that will open this room up to space.
Oh. Can I do it not from here?
Jeff, do the capsules look like they have, the canisters need to be maneuvered by hand, or is there a way that gets them from the drill to that room?
It looks like maneuvered by hand. Yep.
In zero G.
Yep.
Are there any, like...
They're attached to the drill currently, but it looks like they'll each have to be loaded, kind of like loading a gun.
Does it look like there's any way, like, maneuvering devices?
Yes. You can see that there is definitely some air-based propulsion, light propulsion systems on the spacesuits.
I'm gonna get in the spacesuit.
What are you doing?
You know, I don't trust this place, and this will help.
Help with what?
In case we have decompression occur.
I'm gonna start putting on a spacesuit.
Sure.
I'm gonna say, you know, decompression is probably better than floating out in space until you suffocate.
You know, if it comes to that, we can always puncture the suit.
That's true. I do have a sword, and I'll whip the sword.
Yeah, probably don't want to do that in a spacesuit.
Alright, no spacesuit until I need it, then.
Why Europa instead of Ganymede, though?
I don't know. Europa's got a better name.
Yeah?
Nailed it.
So is anyone not wearing a spacesuit when you open this hatch?
Wait, what? You're opening a hatch?
What?
Larry wanted to open the hatch.
Yeah.
Oh, and Jesus. I'm absolutely putting on a spacesuit.
And drive a drill.
If you're going to be opening a hatch that leads out into space,
smoke.
On a spacesuit.
Work the winch over there.
50-50 on putting on the spacesuit.
Larry, put on a spacesuit and get into that driving location.
Why is there an initiative thing
all right
there?
Because Jeff wants to kill us all.
Jeff,
I want to ask Smoke to handle the winch to lower the drill.
Oh,
and I want
okay.
to ask Larry to get into the driving location for the drill.
And then what are you going to do?
I'm going to go to where there's a computer terminal and, like, strap myself in next to whatever I can do to secure myself there.
So you're going to try to get the samples?
Yeah, I'm going to try to do what I can.
Gustav had really better be worth killing him for all this.
We could send a robot down with Larry and see if the robot...
No! God, it'll just try to choke him to death or something. I mean, I trust Larry, but jeez.
Okay, then let's do this.
Alright, so how this is going to get resolved... this is a thing in Savage Worlds that is basically a skill challenge.
Yay!
These are called
skill challenges.
Dramatic tasks.
Oh my goodness.
Is that
dramatic failures?
That is part of it. Is that you're gonna have a certain number of turns, which is 5, and over those 5 turns, in order to successfully maneuver this drill down to the planet without crashing it, you need to get a total of 5 successes. That might make it sound like you need to succeed every single turn, but note that raises count as additional successes. So if you get 2 one turn, then you can fail on another turn. One person who thinks they have a skill that can help maneuver this drill down, that person is going to be the actor in this. Other people can roll to help if they would like. Since this is a very complicated and difficult thing to do with a team this small, the actor is going to be getting a -2 penalty. The helpers are going to be rolling for a 4 and without the penalty.
So I have driving at a D4. I have throwing at a D6 if we think that throwing it would be helpful.
You're pretty certain, looking at this and given the propulsion systems of the suits, that if you want to realistically help with this, you're going to need to be with it in space.
Is there a problem with it if I only have one arm? Are there any spacesuits that accommodate a one-armed man?
Yes, all of them.
We can just duct tape the other arm.
Great. Boy, I am going to get in a spacesuit and I'm going to say, this is the dumbest decision I've ever made in my life. I'm going to put on my psionic shield helmet and then I'm going to get out there.
You still don't trust me?
No, you're fine. It's all the other crazy shit that's going to happen around here that I don't trust. And also...
So is someone...
It's also your weird spider monster.
Is someone laying claim to main actor here?
I have a D4 in driving and or piloting.
So...
Is there...
That's better than the rest of us have got.
Is there a difference between agility and... Do we need agility or anything like that? Or how does that work? I don't remember.
You don't default to traits... If you have, basically what traits let you do is buy up better skills.
Oh.
Like it makes it easier to buy up higher skills. So if you've got the skill at a D4, you've got the skill at a D4.
Yeah.
So you both have a D4 for a drive pilot?
Yep. I don't have any piloting, but I have some climbing.
I can shoot and fight and or climb also. That's it.
Boy, it is unfortunate that we have five turns to get five successes.
A D4 is our best die for this.
Jeff, here's what I'm going to do. Huh? I'm going to come up with some weird fancy shenanigans to try to get the sword on the outside of the suit.
You could draw the sword before you put the suit on. That's fine.
No. Because I only have one arm, Jeff. You have to realize the problem here. I'm going to attach the sheath of the sword to the outside of the suit.
Space tape.
And I'm going to tape it in.
All right. So
I have a sword taped to my suit and a sword. I have a sheath taped to the suit and a sword taped into the sheath.
Jeff, what matters? Fritz is joining me in my suit.
Oh, that is weird.
That's weird.
You're
dude.
Pretty. You're aware Fritz can. Fritz does not need to do that.
Fritz can breathe in space.
Fritz can live in space just fine.
Okay. Fritz will cling to my suit.
Sure. Fritz now is the reason that we need military personnel. He's going to turn into a
claw the suit.
He will gently hold onto the suit without killing me.
For this little...
For these little horror hands.
So, just double checking. There is no other skill that you guys are looking to use for this, right?
That's what I got.
I could use knowledge science at a D4. Would notice let me do anything?
You can roll notice right now, but no, not for this.
Oh, roll notice.
If
please.
I can shoot.
Jesus, please.
Give it to me, but...
A five,
you
know.
With a five, you can find that there are some emergency spacesuit repair canisters that are there that look like you could use to seal up a damaged spacesuit.
Are there three?
There's a bunch. Well, there's a lot.
I'll make sure that I have a few and that each of them have a few also.
I'll take a couple.
When things go terrible, we now can repair our spacesuits.
I'm glad that you said when and not if.
Jeff, would repair work to assist?
Yeah, you could use repair to assist for sure.
And finally, Jeff, how about psionics? Would psionics work in any way for this?
Telling Larry what to do.
Psionics, I would allow you to assist with psionics, keeping people cool. Yeah.
Yeah, you can control Larry's pitiful mind.
Like calming their emotional state, calming their nerves, that type of thing.
Sure.
That's cool.
I mean, I have primarily social skills. I mean, I'm the best person you want on a space station with robots and zombies.
Unfortunately, the only real humans you guys already locked up.
Yeah, well, if we're asking for it. So,
you're in jail.
That's what they get for siding with the creepy supercomputer.
I'll assist with psionics, but I can't do psionics as the primary role. So.
Probably not, no.
Okay, so we have a D4.
We have a D4, and I have a D10 to assist you guys.
It's a D4 minus 2.
D4 minus 2, and we can give a plus 1 each if we succeed. Best. So yes. We have, if we both succeed, Lee, we get a D4 for Larry.
This is gonna
be
great.
Trying to hit 4.
You're trying to hit 5.
5?
You also get your wild card. The reason I'm asking who the primary actor is because if the primary actor is dealt a clubs card, there's a complication.
So the good news on this is if we roll a 4, we at least have a 5. So we have a 25% chance of getting a 5.
That's if you and I both...
Oh, my
both...
God.
Right?
What?
Right?
How?
Because the 4 explodes. So if we roll a d4 and
that's
get a 4,
true.
It's at least a 5.
But that's if you and I both also succeed.
That's why Savage World probability curves are so wonky.
But we also get a d6, right? It's a wild card.
You also
right.
get to roll your wild card die. Which
so it's a d6 minus 2.
Yeah, baby.
The saving grace of this. So... when you guys start this thing off and you have your repair canisters and stuff, the ground will open up and there is no airlock. Realistically, it probably removes air from the chamber, some of the air first, but when the thing opens, there is a bunch of air that is released and the whole drill rumbles as it's being pulled towards the ground. But the whole the lock will open up, and then the winch will start to maneuver and start to slowly lower the thing down. It looks like as the thing is orbiting, or as the thing is opening, the ship orbits closer down towards the moon, and you guys can start trying to guide this thing down if you would like.
We're the bad guys. Is there a bad guys here?
Don't worry about it. So, Ebo, you did not get Delta Club.
What's up?
And that means that there is no complication. You are the main actor, I believe. So you can make your roll to try and guide this massive drill through space down to this moon.
And I'm at minus 2.
You are at a minus 2 because this is a ridiculously difficult task, yes.
And we haven't assisted him yet?
You haven't assisted him, right. So, normally in Savage Worlds, dramatic tasks are at a minus 2 because they're typically difficult things to do.
Okay. And I need to get a what to succeed?
You need a 4.
I thought you said a 5.
You want a 4.
Okay.
You have 5 turns to get a 4 5 times. If you get an 8, that counts as 2, though. So.
What if you get, like, a 12?
That
or
counts
16?
As 3.
So all you need to roll is a D4 4 times and get 4s.
Well, I can get a pop to D6 and we're 40% of the way there.
So you guys can do it in whatever order you want to, and you can spend bennies as power gamey as you want to. So
all right, here's what we need
that's
to do.
That's what I'm looking
for. How many bennies do you have, Ebo?
3?
You all start with 3.
We're going to be spending bennies every time we don't succeed.
So, but we can take our turns in whatever order we want, Jeff, is what you're saying?
Right, so,
yes,
we can roll this first, and then he can roll to try to succeed.
You guys are very much not equipped for this, and that is fine.
I don't like that you said that's fine.
Oh, okay,
what?
So I will try to calm us down with psionics, apparently.
Sure.
Well, I mean, you also maybe are making Larry smarter, because let's be honest.
Dude, I have never been out in space.
I mean, for what it matters, my sonic powers are fear, mind reading, and beast friend.
They all work. Pretty sure those all work on me.
Oh, God. Hey, I think I help.
Right.
What does that give?
You're getting a plus 1 to your roll.
Minus 1.
Right, so if Lee also helps you, you don't have a penalty.
Alright. I'm rolling my D4 and D6 that both explode. Neither one of them did. You get nothing.
How much do you need to...
One.
I only took the highest one. I needed a 4.
I got it. Okay.
Alright, so you're rolling a D4 minus... A D4 and a D6 minus 1. And desperately praying for some explosions.
Yeah.
That's not it at all. Nope, that's a 0.
All right.
Like a Benny.
So,
spend a Benny.
If you spend a Benny, you do get to reroll both dice.
Oh, but they're okay, still both negative one, right?
Yeah.
Oh, well, maybe we should wait on the Bennies.
Yeah, man.
No... five successes in five turns.
Yeah, we can do it, dude.
Okay, sure.
You guys both give me plus one. We all have Bennies left.
I've never run this game, man. I don't know. We're just playing it like by the book. We'll see what happens.
Fuck fast and loose. Fast and loose.
I'm on.
Are you spending a Benny or not?
Nope. No. Fuck it. This is not his best chance.
It's not remotely my best chance. My best chance.
Okay.
Is
so.
Okay.
We need to do how many?
You need to get five total successes. This is round one.
Okay. Oh, so do I need to get it? How many turns do we have?
Five.
So I need a success.
We need a successful
on...
turn.
Each turn. Okay.
But you can't
well,
get two successes if you get it
right.
I like that you keep telling us that, but it's literally impossible. It's not literally. It's probably impossible. I mean, I did roll, like, 4d6 on 1d6.
Yes, that's what we need to do.
You need to randomly get your dice to explode. So,
you need to get 17
you, or
on
are you not spending a Benny on this?
I am not.
Okay. No, we're better than this.
So, the first turn, to describe a bit, it is really rocky as this thing starts to go up because you're immediately, you're still at zero G, but there's all this air pressure that shoots everything in a wild direction. There are no mishaps or complications. You're all able to hang on to this thing. And as you look around, space is strangely dark sometimes and strangely bright, depending on what you're looking at. It's really messed up and weird. You're all a bit disoriented. This winch is dropping this thing so much faster than you probably expected, and it's very difficult to keep up with it, and it's almost like a panic, like it feels like this thing is going to just crash into this planet, and it does not look like that sturdy of a drill, and you guys can also make perception checks for free.
Notice, sorry.
I got a 2.
Got a 4.
Yeah, 4 makes it.
Oh.
Evo's taking the high road and refusing to roll.
You still get your wild.
I'm focusing on this. Focus.
Okay. Yeah.
Do you want him to not pay attention to the drill? No.
Murray, you can see, when you get against the backdrop of a different moon, there look to be small yet winged figures approaching as you guys are through space as you guys are lowering this drill.
That seems impossible.
I'm gonna say, what kind of shit is this?
They don't seem to be using the wings to fly per se, but they're definitely approaching.
That looks weird. I will not tell Larry so he's not distracted.
This thing has its own... You said these suits have their own propulsion, right?
Yeah.
Good!
Smoke, deal with that.
Larry, how many of them are there?
Alright, Larry did not get clubs on the second turn, so you guys lucked out again. And you guys can continue trying to move this thing if you'd like.
How far away are the things that Rory pointed out?
They're moving really fast. It's very difficult to gauge. Especially in space.
Ebo, don't roll yet.
Don't roll yet.
I'm rolling because.
Okay, I'm gonna.
You don't
I'm
know what
help.
Your penalty is yet, so
oh,
I.
Oh yeah, I know.
So don't roll yet because we'll find out if.
All right, I'm gonna help with driving.
So I assist. So you're only at a minus one and then a minus two.
It's only a minus. It's only a minus zero. I got an assist with four.
Four on the second one.
All right, so you get a success. You're able to stabilize the drill. It was a really panicky moment. Rory, are you still assisting with Cyanix?
Yes.
Yeah, you feel your nerves calm, and your one-armed friend puts an arm on it to stabilize it, and you're able to stabilize it sitting in that seat. Ebo, are you going to rev the drill? Or are you going to leave it idle at this point?
Leave it idle.
Okay. Yeah, you can leave the drill idle. It looks like the whole thing's going to be a lot more stable if you leave it idle. Rory, are you tracking those figures?
Sure.
Yeah, they're getting closer. They seem like they're flying straight towards this moon.
But not us?
Correct. They're flying towards the surface of the moon where you're headed.
Okay. Yeah. How many of them are there?
Looks to be three. One of them seems a bit bigger than the others. As they get a bit closer, you can see some sort of jagged features, reminiscent of your happy little friend. Except these are much bigger and humanoid looking with wings.
These are humanoid flying space spiders?
Not spiders, but like almost like a space bony birdman type shapes.
Well, they're probably friendly guys.
All right. Next turn, Larry did not get clubs again. Also, I haven't seen a Joker yet.
So good.
So, you guys All right. can continue as you're heading down on the
So it doesn't look like they're going to come directly for us, so I don't need to try to fight them while this is happening, which is really good news for me.
So is a Benny a reroll or an addition to a roll? Or
I think it's a reroll. Right? I'm going to check again here.
I succeeded.
Forget about checking
the D4.
If it's worse, just pretend it didn't happen.
Hey, we both assisted you, Larry.
Oh, I did the wrong one.
All you need to do is roll.
D2.
Oh, hey!
Oh, shit. Alright, so third turn, you get your second success. Larry, this is feeling pretty good. You're sitting in that seat. You feel like you've been stable for long enough that you could probably turn on that drill and it wouldn't affect your future rolls.
Do it.
Yeah. You can turn the drill on. The thing starts turning. You're thinking that you might minimize the negative effects of a crash landing if it can at least stick into something. But you're not quite on course, but you're doing pretty well.
Jeff, can I tell what area of Europa we're going towards?
It looks like a upper center.
So not
Jeff
like
knows as much about
not,
Europa as I do.
Not equatorial or polar, upper center.
Sure. Okay. Like a little above the equator.
Medium.
Have we hit the atmosphere yet?
Yeah. You guys are hitting a light atmosphere. Your spacesuits seem to be defending you admirably.
Awesome.
Yeah. Round four. Is that correct?
No.
Yeah, round
four.
Three.
Four.
Oh, it is.
Four. Shit.
It's round four.
Alright, man. We gotta get these.
Ebo Lux out again. No clubs. Okay. No one's got a Joker.
No clubbing tonight, guys.
Joker. And just really awesome Star Wars combat happening.
Is it Jack?
No, that's not that's a Jack. Different Jack.
Two Jacks.
Alright. So, you guys can continue on turn four.
All right. Well, it can't possibly get worse than it already is.
Oh no! Roll a Benny.
No.
Use a Benny.
You need to Benny that.
You need me to use a Benny on a calm emotions check.
You can wait
yes.
until Evo rolls if you want. Like I said, you can power game this as hard as you want.
Yes, okay. Maybe.
I'm also using a Benny.
Let's do an Evo roll first. Or
I succeeded.
Okay, so
on my Benny.
Evo, you're at maybe minus one, maybe zero.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna use a Benny.
You get both rolls for the Benny, if that matters to you.
Get the wild card and the regular one.
Okay, I guess okay. I have to use a Benny
it's exploding.
The D4 does explode.
Oh, so that's right. So that will succeed no matter what, with a minus one.
Listen, but we still
roll
want
it.
Them.
Roll it.
Three.
We need two successes.
that's not going to give us two success.
No, either. It's not. No.
So I don't need to roll a Benny because...
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
You are correct,
that is
sir.
True.
So on the fourth turn, you get your third success. Rory, you can see those creatures are approaching the surface of the moon very quickly. And again, you can see them more clearly now. You all, realistically, other than Larry, can see them, because Larry's oblivious. They are humanoid creatures made completely of this black sort of bone-like substance. Huge bone wings that look like they have razor-sharp edges to them. If you had to guess, Roy, with your science skill, these creatures probably can survive extreme amounts of pressure and heat and cold. They look pretty vicious. And we're going to move on to turn 5. You guys can see the planet's getting bigger and bigger. God, Larry, it looks like you're maybe going to do this thing. So turn 5, and you guys have 3 successes. Larry did not roll clubs.
All right, well,
I really want this to happen, but anyway.
Let's just keep doing this.
I'll assist. And getting a raise on the assist doesn't matter.
Oh, right? Man, popped.
Jeff?
I don't know. I should probably check.
Because I raised on that assist, like, hard. I just got a 14.
You got a 14?
14 and 1.
Why can't Larry have that?
Maybe a Benny allows you to switch with someone else.
Rory, plus assisting. 1 for every success and raise his companions achieve.
Oh, dude. You got a 14.
That's 3. A success and 2 raises?
Well. So 2 raises would be plus 3, and mine would be plus 4. So you're at a plus 2.
Okay.
And I should roll a d6 just in case, but no. I haven't been rolling the d6 most of the time. I'm rolling the d10.
Alright, so you're at plus 3.
Wait.
No,
so
Rory,
no. Leah's plus 3 and you're plus 2, so I'm plus 3.
I'm plus.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. 9 is a raise, you're right.
Okay. Plus 3.
So you're at least getting a success.
You can do better.
I'm going to use a Benny.
We need 2.
Opt.
Yay.
Got it.
But we might get even more. Nope.
We didn't.
Nope.
We definitely don't. Oh, we didn't.
That is true.
So you guys got 2 this round?
Yes.
Yes.
So on the 5th round, you get 5. You are completely stabilized. Or sorry, on the 4th round. All right. Is this 5th round?
That was the 5th
round.
Yeah. 5th round, you get 5. You completely stabilize, manage to succeed against some pretty harrowing odds. It is still an ordeal when this thing crashes. I mean, to call it a landing would be generous. When this thing crashes into the moon,
you're welcome.
You guys are able to hold on as the rest of your bodies like sort of float upwards as this thing crashes. But Ebo, you've got the drill already going from before. And the thing latches into the surface really quickly and begins drilling into there. And you've got a bunch of controls in front of you, Ebo. It looks like you can drill deeper. It looks like you can add more power to the drill. It looks like you can tell it to drill slower. Like, what are you doing?
Now, I do have the piloting and or drive ability, but I am illiterate and I cannot read what these say.
I knew it! I knew you couldn't read, you bastard!
Would you like to roll a d3 or press no buttons?
Oh my god, I knew it! Oh shit. Oh my god.
yeah, I'm gonna look closely at him. I'll just press a button.
Okay. Yeah. You guys will hear and see the drill revving up, and it starts drilling faster. There are little chunks of ice, and I guess maybe a little water, but mostly ice that's floating off into space at this point. The atmosphere does not seem to be all that thick here. There's a little bit of gravity, but not a lot. And Rory, it looks like one of the canister needs to be loaded.
How would that happen?
You would just remove it from where it's stationed and load it basically into the middle of the drill shaft.
Yeah. I guess Smoke maybe can do that.
With his one arm?
I don't think I can be much help on that. Does it require agility or strength?
It doesn't require a roll.
Jeff, I have the hindrance anemic.
Awesome.
The spacesuit is so heavy.
Hey, Lee, are you there?
I am, yes. What am I doing? Do you need help moving the canister?
It's so heavy in space.
I'll say, don't worry, the one-armed man is here to save you.
Jeff, for what it matters, any sickness, disease, environmental effect, or fatigue, I subtract 2 from my rolls related to that.
All right, good call. You can get Smoke. Are you going to load the canisters?
Yes.
All right.
For what it's worth, I am spectacularly strong.
The drill stabilizes, and you guys can load the canisters. All 3 of them will go in, and it looks like after that the drill takes care of things on its own. You will see the creatures that are approaching. They will land on the moon, maybe like 100 meters away from you guys, and they will start walking along the ice towards you guys. Are you guys doing anything as they're approaching?
Yep. I'm going to reach into my backpack. I'm going to pull out a hand grenade.
Smoke? Okay. Let's see if they're friendly.
They're not friendly.
Hey, Jeff, can I try to read their mind?
Sure.
Okay, this is... I spend power points, and then we make an opposed roll.
Okay.
I
love everything about this.
I will tell you what you're rolling. Opposed smarts.
Smarts, you say?
Yes. So I will roll my psionics versus their smarts. I also get a +2 bonus on any opposed psionic roll since I am a mentalist.
Okay.
Because this is the one thing I'm good at.
All right. Well, they definitely have minds, Rory. So there's
okay.
That.
Oh, well, now that we have that established.
Okay.
Bam.
I got an 11, Jeff.
Okay. This is a post smart?
Yes.
Oh, no. Okay. I got a 1.
Is that I have 2 raises above them?
Yep.
Okay. First of all, that means they are not aware that I'm reading their mind.
Okay.
And second of all, that means I get 3 truthful answers from their mind about things that I ask them. Basically, I get to read their mind for 3 questions.
Oh, okay. Go ahead.
What is their current intentions?
Their current intentions is to kill the people raping this sanctuary.
How do they plan on doing that? Like, what tactic?
Approaching to close quarters and decapitating you with their razor wings.
How many more of them are there?
Millions.
Okay. Wonderful. They're hostile. Kill them.
It's hand grenade time, ladies and gentlemen. I have a lot of these. I'm ready for this.
Okay.
Mind you, I have not looked up what any of the grenades do.
I was looking up the power as I used it.
So, the drill is going, currently. And the drill is based, you have loaded the canisters, the drill is on autopilot at this point.
Okay.
They are going to close to medium range with you guys. They are walking along the surface of this moon, more like skipping along. They seem very accustomed to low gravity environments. and they move extremely quickly. But that's their turn. This is probably Rory?
I did not put a name in because you said we didn't have names.
Does anyone else wish they had brought a bazooka?
Your turn, Rory.
Jeff, how far? I don't know what ranges are like at all.
They're like medium range.
Which is how far?
I don't know.
Why
are you asking?
Sorry. The range of my power is smarts times 2.
What's your smarts?
D10.
Yeah, let's say they're within range.
Okay, this is a large burst template. Can I hit all of them?
Yes, they're close together.
Okay, then I will try to cause fear in them.
Awesome. Okay. What do I need to roll?
First of all, are they wild cards or extras?
They're extras.
I think I have to roll to try to activate it first.
Awesome.
And then it goes off.
Cool.
Which I succeed on.
Yep, because you need a 4.
And I lose some more power points to do this. And then they will be... They need to make a fear check. Did I get a raise? I did.
Yeah, you
so
did.
They're a fear check at minus 2.
Okay, so that's spirit?
I think so. Spirit roll, yes. Spirit roll at minus 2.
Oh, jeez. I think they're doing well.
Yeah. So that means that nothing happens.
I think the dice are on my side. What are you thematically doing?
I am projecting an image of absolute terror in their minds.
I mean, they definitely flinch, but soldier on. Like, where you get the impression from being in their minds that this is definitely like a military scouting party.
Okay.
Oh, shit. Rory, you can roll smarts. Like,
I am guessing that Fritz's horror also terror doesn't affect them since they look basically the same as him.
Right.
Smarts, you say?
Yes. With a success, Rory, you get the feeling that there's something extremely unified about the ways that their minds work.
Okay.
Yeah. He prefers to be called Smoke.
All right, he prefers to be called Smoke. He's going to be throwing a thermal grenade at them. okay, here.
Okay.
I make a throwing roll, right?
Water hasn't been seen on Europa ever, and you're going to make some.
What is a thermal grenade?
Well, it's bad news. Small blast target. It's a small blast template, I think. SBT.
They're very close together. We've established this.
It may set targets on fire. It ignores all but sealed armor. It does 3d10 damage if it hits. So, I'm gonna throw it.
There is technically oxygen.
Worse for me.
There is technically some oxygen. Let's say the grenade doesn't just. Not
I'm gonna
fire,
spend a Benny.
Okay.
That's how I roll.
Sure. Are you rolling for their defense stat or whatever?
I have no idea how this works, man.
Their parry?
Maybe? I don't know how it works.
Probably. Does it say you have to roll to hit? Or you are currently rolling to hit right now?
Something like that. Let me look in the actual book to see if there's a section for throwing things.
I mean, long story short, you did. Their parry is 5.
Okay, neat. Good enough for me.
Because I think you got an 8.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, so here's what I'm going to do. I am going to throw a thermal grenade at them. It does 3d10 points of damage and ignores all armor.
Okay.
It ignores all but sealed armor. It may set targets on fire. It doesn't say what the may is. It just says may set targets
on fire. It's probably not going to set targets in space on fire.
Well, you know what, Jeff?
But we'll say it's able to explode. How about that?
All right. It does 3d10 points of damage. I hope this is a lot. It's 14 damage.
And
that's my
armor?
Health.
Yunor's armor, yes.
Yeah, they kind of hesitate for a moment from the psychic barrage. You can throw your little thermal detonator out there.
And then I draw a sword.
It burns them up, and you guys can see a little bit of melted flesh ooze out of that black bone as they all sort of melt down to the ground and kind of float a little in space as you draw your sword. Rory, your mental connection just jaggedly disconnects when that happens. It is like instant. And okay. with your smarts roll from before, you're pretty sure that it was more than just the three of those that noticed that happening mentally.
We probably have more incoming then.
Do you think they were pissed off by the explosion?
I think they were angry that... I think we're someplace that they don't want us to be, and there are millions of them.
Wait, did you say millions? Look, I don't have that many grenades.
We should probably hurry this up.
Is there a way to... Hey, Larry, can you hurry this up?
Hey, did I press the go faster button before?
It looked like it, yeah.
Can't press it again.
Yeah. No, the drill starts going even faster. The whole thing shakes as it's drilling even
got
faster.
It.
Are you still sitting on the seat?
Yeah, I don't have any weapons.
That's awesome. Okay, you're still sitting on the seat. It's shaking back and forth. A light turns green on the display.
Okay, got it. Green is good.
And there's like a sort of a zoop, and one of the canisters hits the top.
Do we have to load another canister?
No, it's like it's coming back out of the center of the drill.
Right, we have to load another. I thought we had like multiple canisters or something.
You've loaded all three into the drill at this point. This is the first one coming back out.
Ah, so we're just waiting for the next two, basically.
The next two will eventually pop back out. The green light will start to flash brightly a number of times, and then a smiley face appears on the screen.
What?
I'll point at it and I'll say,
"Now you're speaking my Changuage."
We're good to go.
Can we send this thing back up, or do we have to float up there? Because that's
Jeff, is there a way to reverse to pull it back?
Rory, you can see on the screen. There's a button for reeling you guys back in.
Okay, hit that button.
Okay, I'll press it.
Alright. And you're going to attempt to get the drill safely back into the ship.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, here we go again.
Here we go.
Okay, I need to take painkillers before we start this shenanigans.
Rory, you are given a joker, which means you get a +2 to all of your actions and damages if you're doing damage.
I'm trying to keep people calm and motivated.
Uh-huh. Do it right. Throw the exploding 10.
Or a 2.
Hey, success is success.
I still give you a success.
Success is success. And he wouldn't have gotten that. Not been the Joker. Did Ibo get a club? No, Ibo did not.
I'm so good at
it. I like that there's only complications. There's no, benefit for getting a certain suit.
That is... okay. If you get a joker, you get a +2. That's kind of a benefit, but...
Yeah, but 1/4 of the deck is clubs. Only 2 cards in 54 are jokers.
No, you guys got really lucky last time, I think. Because you didn't get a single complication.
Right.
Well, I mean, really lucky.
Well, Jeff,
I'm just keeping up.
I used half my power points in that fight.
Nice.
They come back at 1 per hour.
They had a lot of they had a high spirit, and they got really lucky, I think.
Yeah, if they had failed, they would as extras, they would have been panicked and shaken. Which is run away, fleeing at full pace for a full turn, and then shaken after that.
I'm getting the feeling the system is extremely swingy. Like, extras, either nothing happens to them, or they're done. Gone.
Yeah, I mean, like the fear thing is one of the better dispersed crowds ability that I saw out there, it just makes an entire group of people flee. Extras just, they're panicked if they fail against it. Against wild cards, you still have a chance of being panicked, it's just not automatic.
Alright, Lee, you trying to help with this process?
Yes. Yep. Okay. The first beast called Smoke.
Nice. That's a help. So that's Evo, a help. You are at an even keel.
Zeroed the right the fuck out.
That's
a raise.
Two successes. Look at you. All right.
Club next time.
Turn one, baby.
Ebo, you are illiterate and oblivious, and you just press the right buttons, and that drill drills right out of there, and you are on a perfect trajectory going back towards the ship.
I'm so good at my job.
Larry's the boss.
Man, you are on track for special military upgrades. Maybe you'll get one of those weird spider monsters, too.
Hey, you can guess bird spider monster.
I can drive and pilot, but okay. I'm pretty sure drill is not in my wheelhouse.
Second turn. You guys can continue trying. You are two successes in getting back to the ship.
Mm-hmm. Looks red to me.
Oh, shit. I got 11. And I... Okay. So hold up. I succeeded with a raise.
So that means Ebo gets plus 2 instead of plus 1 from you.
And I give him a plus 1. So he's got
a total of plus 1. Listen to that shit. Oh. That's 8.
That's 2 right there.
Roll that d6. Roll that Savage Worlds. Okay, fair enough.
So we're at 4 at 4 second turn.
4 at the second turn. Yes. Damn. Yeah, basically Larry's getting in the zone. He's totally calm and Smoke is stabilizing things, and you guys are somehow proceeding upwards way more calmly than you proceeded downwards. And turn 3.
The summary execution of the aliens has really helped us out. It really calmed us.
Larry pounds on the panel and says, "I'm so good at this," and he doesn't screw up.
Okay, I succeed, but not with a raise. I help you, but not with a raise.
Right. I don't succeed.
You piece of shit.
So you're testing a total.
Use your bennies.
One.
These characters are corpses or dead men walking anyway.
They kind of are.
I can wait to use my Benny to see if Evo is going to use his to make it matter.
Well... This is
why would I use mine to make it better when I'm rolling a minus one?
What I'm saying is, Jeff said that I can re-roll mine with a Benny after we find out what your roll is.
If you would like, yes.
He said,
"I mean, that's not going to help." We'll shoot for turn 4.
Unless Ebo was re-rolling that, there's no point in me re-rolling mine.
We'll shoot for turn 4.
Moving on to turn 4.
I have one Benny left.
Still no clubs.
Still no clubs. What is this shit? All right, turn 4. You guys for one success.
I don't help.
I help.
Murray does help. Here, I'm minus 1. Come on, baby. Aw. Aw.
That's a 4.
It's technically a success.
All right. And that's what you needed. You guys are going to be able to get back in the ship.
Jesus. I feel like Team of 12 was maybe overstating the danger of this scenario.
You don't know how lucky you got.
Because we never got a club. Because no one had got a club in the entire... I don't think you drew a single club.
No, it was just spades and reds.
There were a few spades, yeah.
How it works in Savage Worlds is if a Joker is drawn, the whole deck is reshuffled. So it's very possible to not draw a whole suit. You guys can get the drill safely back in there. It looks like the side room starts blinking green, and you can see that it's starting to eject the canisters.
Can we close the door?
The door closes, yes.
Okay. Oh, good.
So someone else should maneuver these over into that area.
Obviously. I will do it.
Yeah. Smoke, as you maneuver them,
are they clear?
Two of them are.
Hmm. What do you mean? Like, is there nothing in them?
Two of them look like they just have water in them. One of them has water and a creature swimming in that water.
I'll, like, back up a little bit.
Yeah. It looks kind of like a seal almost, except it has iridescent scales, very sharp features, and it's sort of turning in on itself, swimming up and down really fast. It looks like it's freaking out.
I'm going to say, these creatures have never been in captivity before because they never came across us assholes.
Hey, Jeff, does this have animal intelligence?
With your psionics, you can tell that it does not. It has normal intelligence.
Oh, then it's not automatically my friend.
Come on!
But I mean, if you're psionically making as like a light connection with it, you can tell that this is a real thinking mind that is in that tube.
Well, unfortunately, I can't actually do mental communication. I can read minds, cause fear, and befriend animals. I can't actually telepathy yet.
Sure.
So wait, this is kidnapping?
Yeah, we're totally kidnapping this thing.
Wait a second.
Let's just move on and get this done with.
Can they track it? I mean, can they track it? Can they follow us back to Earth?
Probably.
Are we setting off Independence Day? Oh, hey, I've seen Independence Day. Are we setting off Independence Day? Is this our fault?
I don't know. I think if it's anybody's fault, it's Newman's.
It's Gustav's fault. Let's go cut that guy's fucking head off now that we've got this ready.
Hey. Let's just put this in where it's supposed to go and move on with life.
What do we feed it? What's it call itself?
Cut their heads off.
Hey, look. What? I think we should call it Larry. After Larry, the guy who guided us so righteously down to the surface.
That's too confusing.
It's an honorific.
We could call him Jarl.
Jarl Larry.
So are you or are you not putting the canisters in their place?
I'm putting the canisters in their place.
All right. Yeah.
We'll call him Fish.
Fishy.
The creature freaks out while you're doing that, but the canisters eventually stabilize.
Does it have eyes?
It does, yeah.
Can I try to make eye contact with it?
Yeah, it'll look at you. It has green eyes. It'll stare at you.
Huh. I'll say, well, that's not the freakiest thing that's ever happened to me, but it's in the top two. So I'm going to leave.
Jeff, I'll walk up towards it.
Uh-huh.
I'll hold Fritz out towards it.
It panics.
I'll take Fritz away.
Okay. It still panics, but...
I'll say, yeah, that little bugger freaks everybody out.
Fritz is friendly.
Friendly doesn't make it less weird.
You don't know that.
Yeah, I do know that. It's still weird, even if it's friendly.
These could be really common back on Earth.
Oh, that's actually true. Well, it freaked me out. Look, I'm freaked out by anything with more than the requisite number of legs. Two.
What about fewer than the normal number of legs? I'll point at this.
That's fine.
Okay,
I don't like quadrupeds.
I'll
don't like
put my hand on the glass.
Tripeds.
Sure. It just backs two. Up and freaks out.
Well, I'm not so good at not scaring things, apparently. Can I try to calm it down with persuasion? Just through, like, kind of...
Yeah.
Calming motions?
Sure.
Got a 7.
Yeah, you can get a success. I mean, it calms down enough to pay attention to you. Rory I mean, it's like something that's claustrophobic being stuck in a small, closed area. Like, you can tell that it's just not comfortable due to its surroundings and situation. But it'll calm down a little.
I'm going to say there's no way this thing survives this trip. I'm telling you. 2 years? You kidding me?
I mean, you do realize we have to go back and cryosleep to survive this trip.
Shit. We need to kill those guys. They're going to take all of our air.
Yeah. This is a really poorly designed space mission.
I can land the ship.
That's not the point. Let's go back to the command chamber and see if we can...
Sure. Let's go back to the command center.
Get this thing at least going backwards. God, everything about this is terrible.
Sure.
Because those flying spider human things are gonna want to kill us.
Yeah, they really are. We need to leave immediately. As fast as possible.
Yeah. Why will they want to kill us?
Because we went to their secret area and stole that serpent thing.
And also, I mean, not to put a fine point on it, but I totally murdered three of them.
He'll high five you. He'll go, high five.
I will high five you. And I'll say, listen, I may be the first person who's ever murdered an alien.
More importantly, I think they had some sort of mental connection, and that means that they probably all know that you specifically murdered them.
Well, I was wearing a helmet.
You'll high five you even harder and go, special military! Bam!
You guys will feel the ship moving.
That makes three of us.
Let's go back to the command chamber quickly.
You can get to the command chamber.
Oh, jeez.
And it, there are, like, error messages blinking constantly on all of the screens.
Oh,
I'm going to say, as I'm getting back, I'm going to say, you know, that robot said that Gustav was a really good programmer or whatever. Everything is erroring out. He's clearly terrible at his job. What a piece of shit that guy. He lied to everybody.
It's saying, propulsion systems failing, unknown error, over and over and over again. It looks like you're heading... towards the gas giant.
What would be causing our propulsion systems to fail? Is there like a blockage or something? Do I have to go out there and hit something with a sword? Because I'll do it.
It looks like the ship doesn't really understand why the propulsion systems aren't sending them in the other directions. It looks like they're on and firing.
Are there windows?
Where are propulsion systems?
On the outsides of the ship.
Like just all over?
Yep.
Can we turn them off?
Would you like to?
Yes.
You can turn them off. You start heading towards the gas giant faster.
Oh. Let's
turn them back on,
turn them back on, and try to get out of its gravity well.
Sure.
Look, can you, like, fire those things? Do we have, like, boosters? I don't know.
Can we do a gravity slingshot? I don't know how to program this stuff.
I'm going to go looking at, Jeff, I'm going to start looking at the windows to try to get an eye on the propulsion systems.
I like that Larry was going to argue with the gravity slingshot.
what Larry was thinking is, but who would hold the slingshot?
Yeah, there's no, doesn't work. Doesn't work in space.
Yeah, you can look out the window. It looks like you're almost being pulled towards the gas giant. The propulsion systems are definitely doing something, just not enough.
I'm gonna think to myself, I heard this in Star Trek, and I'm gonna say, full power to aft thrusters. we need more than impulse power? Man, things are really starting to come back to me.
Look at Star Trek.
Oh my god. Jeff, where did you find all this fucking music?
Here and there.
I've been collecting music for bizarre space games.
Yeah.
All of your horror game ideas are space ones, aren't they?
Probably.
Scariest thing in the world.
I love space.
Space is pretty cool.
Yeah. Space is great. You should have a constant space game.
Yeah, gee, I feel like there's somebody who was gonna run a game like that, but for some reason it didn't work out, and then nobody understood why, and then it didn't happen.
I was throwing out my mad space knowledge to my parents the other day.
Yep. Did they also punch you in the testicles for everything?
No, but
good. They should. They owe you one on my behalf.
Sorry, I'm waiting until Rory gets back if that wasn't obvious.
Yeah, no. Got it.
That's why I started talking about people, his parents punching him in his testicles.
Okay. I do actually have to be right back.
Okay. So, part of what I've been considering is that I kind of want to run a space horror dread game.
Nice.
During the marathon thing.
Awesome.
And I'm probably just going to hook up like a camera and stream it like regular style.
Nice.
Over there. I want to get Zach and Yusuf because apparently Yusuf's a big... No, is it Peachy? One of them's a big chicken.
Awesome.
And that'll be fun.
Sweet.
Oh, hey, you said you were moving next weekend. Where are you moving to?
Santa Monica.
I assumed it would be closer to Lisa's work.
Yeah.
For... what I'm going to call potentially obvious reasons.
Yeah, that'll be, it'll be a minute drive, so it'll be really good.
That's way better than up to 2 hours, probably.
Yeah.
You know,
no,
me and Jenny found that out the hard way.
I mean, we've been back and forth on that road. It's all... It is what it is. Like, different.
Yeah, it's, What Jenny and I did was we fucked it. we took the low road. We just left. But I realized you guys have more actually attaching you to the place than me and Jenny do.
Right. And I mean, we'll see on that even, but it's gonna be a good move. It's just getting everything ready and able to do this stuff. It's like the sort of thing where I'd like to get it done in like a day if possible.
Yeah. It's like for us moving was super easy because we got a trailer hitch for Jenny's car. Like you can just do that. They like attach it to the undercarriage or whatever.
Yeah.
And then we fit everything in one of those U-Haul trailers.
Right.
And it's like between that and the inside of Jenny's car, we were like, that's all the possessions we had. We had hardly anything. So it's like super easy for us to move.
Yeah, we got a couch and
yeah, like a bigger bed than we do, and you
TV
get like other stuff.
And
desks.
Piano.
A piano.
Anyway, hurry's back.
Yep. That one's a.
Hey man.
Sorry about that. I don't know how that wasn't first.
So yeah, you guys are getting pulled towards this Rory, you're gonna feel a connection in your head. It's kind of faint at this point. A lot of the systems seem to clear up now that the objective is completed. And you'll see, Rory, that video you were looking for is completely accessible.
What video?
The Gustav video that you've been seeing bits and pieces of.
What's this faint connection?
Oh, you just feel it in your head. Like it's some sort of powerful psychic force. It's not terribly offensive, but it's there.
Hmm. Let's play this video.
Sure. Yeah, you can watch it and you'll see Gustav. Gustav's an old man with that sort of crown of white hair around more or less baldness. He'll say with sort of like rushed, hushed tones, he'll say, "Look, if you're reading this, then you've survived. I'm giving humanity a chance. It's just one chance, and I know they'll come after you, but maybe there's a chance that you'll be able to make a difference. I've installed a virus that once you reach the moon, you're far enough away from Newman's, my biggest mistake, you're far enough away from her influence that once it fries the connection, you'll be free. You'll have a chance to make a difference. Some might not make it, but if you do, if you're reading this, if you're hearing this, survive and gain your freedom. And that's the end of the message.
Oh shit. Why didn't he send us any women?
Maybe they didn't survive.
God.
Maybe they did.
You know, those people are listed as dead, but they might actually not be dead. They might just be brain dead.
They were listed as dead.
Yeah, they might be physically alive still.
Maybe they just weren't capable enough, and they were...
Just throwing that out there, that they might still be capable of reproduction, just brain dead.
Well, I guess that's an option.
Maybe
but
we
not
should
a very
get
good option.
Darkest.
I was just hoping. I was just hoping for better companionship than you guys. So what are we gonna? We can't even get back to the planet that we came from. Nor do we know anything about it.
Why not?
Do you know anything about Earth aside from pop culture references? Because that's all I know about it.
No, why can't we get back?
Well, because I guess Jupiter's going to eat us or something.
Also,
I'm going to look at Jupiter.
Newman is on Earth and will kill and will make us reconnect or kill us.
Well, can't we just kill it first? I'm really dangerous.
Rur, you feel that presence in your head gets stronger, like something's attempting to make a connection with you.
Yeah. I'll try to send him happy, friendly thoughts.
Alright. Yeah, it's not friendly, but, you will, it's kind of strange for the other two. You will hear, and as you're hearing this, you can't help but speak it. So you guys will hear both sides of this conversation in Rory's voice.
Oh, that's weird.
And, Rory, you will, you will hear, what is the purpose of this invasion?
This is not an invasion.
Return that which we protect and you'll be allowed to leave.
Can we stay?
No.
Does it know that going back is a bad option? How are we supposed to give it back?
We seek sanctuary.
Throw it.
You all will actually see your computer systems flicker a bit. And, it will say, the tools for your sanctuary are within your vessel. Obtain your own sanctuary. We will not give it for nothing.
Do we just... I can throw it back. If that's what it wants, I'd rather not get eaten by Jupiter.
There's there's a red light that'll start blinking in the storage bridge. It's near the back right corner.
I'm gonna go up to the computer and look at the cameras and shit.
That's where those guys were.
It's a dark room. It's quite a bit down and to the right from where the guys are. These are pretty big bridges, but yeah, it's a dark room. You don't see much in there. And there's actually oddly data on that room.
Jeff, I'll try to give it like an image of us tossing the creature back out and see if that's acceptable.
Yeah, you'll hear. That will work.
We apologize for any missteps on our part. We did not realize what we were doing.
Return our charge. You'll be forgiven for the murders. And we will give you control of your vessel.
Thank you. We appreciate any additional assistance you can give us. Smoke, we need to throw that guy back into space.
Yeah, I'm on it. I'm going to start hustling down to the engineering. I'm going to say, Larry, come with me. Come on, let's go.
If you're right. Leaving, I'm barricading myself in here.
Sure.
Are you sure you can throw it?
I mean, I don't know. Between us, we have three arms. We can probably manage.
All right.
And also, between us, we have 2d4 smarts.
You guys did find a number of, like, garbage chute airlocks before, one of which Fritz entered through.
Oh, yeah.
Are you going to eject the canister with the creature in it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There are some winged creatures that will fly by and grab the canister and start flying back to the moon. The electronics on your ship will sort of bzz, bzz, and that access card you have, Rory, you will see like lines of light on it start blinking, its data is being modified, and then the connection is lost, your psychic connection.
Okay. Can I tell what was altered?
It looks like you have complete control over the mission parameters and the ship.
Mission parameters. Survival of three individuals is paramount. I will list the three of us as the primary mission parameters to keep us alive.
Rory, it also looks like a number of core systems related to Newman have been removed.
Excellent.
Wait, were you talking to, like, their Newman?
I was talking to Jupiter.
Is Jupiter like Newman?
If Newman is psychic.
Well, I mean, Newman is like a robot that controls everybody's brains, right?
Yeah, I mean, like, those flying space spider bird things were psychic.
So what's the difference between Newman and Jupiter, then?
I think that's more like a hive mind, a shared consciousness.
It sounds like the same thing.
And Newman is like an artificial construct that plugs into your head?
Oh, like a voluntary hive mind.
Like what bees do, maybe, or something like that.
Oh, well, I don't know much about bees.
I don't know. Right. Anyway.
Let's go see if... Okay, look, it was trying to... There was something in one of these rooms, and there's no lights on. It's near those guys, but it's not in the same room as those guys. Although, if we go there, those guys are definitely going to hear us.
Well, Jeff, you said that we have more control over the systems?
Complete, actually.
Good. Then I want to start telling robots and scrubbing systems that we have to clean this place up.
Sure.
And dispose to put dead bodies and stuff like that in garbage areas.
Yeah.
And clean gore and blood and stuff like that.
Can do that.
Jeff, does it list food reserves or anything like that?
There's plenty of food on this ship, especially with all the dead people.
Are you including people as dead people as food?
No.
Okay.
It means that there was enough food for all the people.
And now
a lot of those people are dead.
Right. Especially not including potential mouths to feed is what I meant, Rory.
Sure.
Hey, look, Jeff, things have gotten weirdly dark on this mission from literally the first word that you said. So.
What?
All right.
Everything's terrible all the time.
What about the oxygen levels?
Oxygen levels seem fine, especially with all the dead people. You might be able to survive the whole trip back if you didn't want cryostasis with all the dead people.
I don't want to go back.
I don't want to go into cryostasis. No, I definitely want to go back. Where else are you going to go?
Well, we have lots of bodies, which we can compost. And if any of the food has seeds in it, we can start hydroponics if we start growing things.
That doesn't matter. I don't want to live out in space with you guys forever.
It's better than being a mind-controlled zombie on Earth.
Yeah, it is. But also, I could at least go back and I could get real mad about stuff.
Well, I guess. This is long-term. If we can compost bodies and grow plants, then we can use the the plans to recycle.
I appreciate your whatever this is, civic mindedness. Look, we need to go find out what's in that room. That's what I'm going to do. You can come with if you want.
Sure.
Yeah, I've never been much of a composter. I don't know if I'd do well with that.
It's a hard enough time regular posting.
You can do fine.
I'm just, oh, I don't know.
I believe in you, Larry, but look, let's go see what it is that was left in there and maybe chop up some of those guys.
So, Lee, you've already been in the engineering room. You know where the outer strut is there. Mm-hmm. So you can take the outer strut if you'd like and avoid where the guys are holed up.
I would love to do that. And if they come anywhere near us, I will chop those bitches up. I don't have a machine gun, but goddamn do I have a sword.
They appear to be holed up and just trying to survive.
Good.
I think I lost my memory again.
Oh man, I might have to go pretty soon.
Oh, we're ending pretty much right now. I'm just waiting for you to get back.
That's good timing. I was like, it seemed like a decent time for that sort of thing, so I wasn't sure.
Oh, shoot, for about 9.
Okay.
Cool. That works perfectly for me.
Your mom works perfectly for me.
You work perfectly for me.
It's true.
I can work at work. Get.
What time are you getting here tomorrow?
I'm gonna pinch your butt.
I hope you do.
12:45.
In the morning? Or in the afternoon?
Just to,
I don't know. Noon?
Noon. Gotcha.
You guys can get to that small room. And as you turn the lights on, we are going to end the session with you guys finding in that storage facility that was dark and undocumented with little to no cameras a number of massive military suits of power armor.
Yes.
That's where the session's at.
You see,
I could blow up the whole goddamn world with this thing.
I could blow up the whole goddamn world.
That doesn't help me.
So, the next session, we'll start with a little bit of power armor creation, as by the book, the science fiction companion book, you guys are going to be able to make your own customized power armor.
Cool.
Yeah.
Is Rory's going to make him...
Is there like a psychic lens on there or some sort? If not...
I don't know, Rory.
He doesn't know.
Nut, here's what's gonna happen. We eject Nick into space and we get one of the soldiers, probably Roland because he's all chromed up, to pilot one of the other suits of power armor.
You do realize that I think the only person with repair and science left in like in this entire quadrant of the galaxy.
That's true, yes.
So this
very
is
true.
Aliens might have
it looks like there's a signal booster.
That's communication range.
It looks like there's a stealth system. That might be helpful.
Yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything that will really help my psionic powers.
Well, either way, I don't think there are things that can stop your psionic powers. So if you're at least armored...
I'm sure my... D4 agility with no ability to pilot is going to be really useful in a...
Basically, I don't think your psionic powers need to scale, because I don't think there's defenses against them either. But,
I certainly don't have defenses
against them. He has a defense against it. He's got a psychic helmet.
Oh, that is true.
That is
you
true.
Specifically have something against my psychic powers.
Well, don't fuck with
about that.
Then.
I have a psionic shield.
All right, so then if I ever run another session of this, it'll probably be very different than the last two. Assumedly, the cliff notes are the ship heads towards Earth with a few disconnected individuals armed to the teeth. And, that's
and also some connected individuals who get suffocated to death in their room because we cut out their life support.
Long story short, those were supposed to be a combat scene, but you guys kind of avoided it using tactics.
Locked up, accident gone.
That cyborg and those people will, they will never make friends with you. And you can do it how you like.
Guns.
What we should do is we should remove the oxygen from the room until they fall unconscious, take them back to the medical wing and have them their implants removed.
If you guys want to, that's you so can. Much more that would be a great would... excuse for those of them that other survive people? Could be a player character if someone else happens to be here.
That is true. So that is what we're doing.
Before we end, just a quick note, since you guys didn't roll clubs, the things that could have happened is that an oxygen tube on your spacesuit gets tangled and snaps off. Pressure from one of the tanks on the drill gets bumped and sends a random person flying into space. And then the other thing that could have happened was basically general purpose complication, and you get an additional minus two on your roll.
Yeah, I'm surprised we lived through that.
So,
yeah.
For those of you watching, this has been another short excursion into the Savage Worlds world. We're all noobs at this, so sorry about that.
Oh man, it gets savage.
There will probably be, I don't know, probably one last session of this at some point. I don't perceive this as going further than three ever.
I don't know, Jeff. This has the makings of a full-on campaign.
It really
I didn't see it going more than two, but we succeeded against all odds.
Yeah. Oh my god. The D6s just did not stop exploding.
the clubs.
I still think that it's hilarious how bad my character is for this situation.
I cannot believe that I ended up playing this character again.
He's very binary. I think he's going to be extremely effective or does nothing.
I made a social character.
Like us.
I made a bonehead, and Evo made an extreme bonehead.
Super bonehead.
I'm just glad we didn't run across any dogs. But I've been expanding it to the idea that my character doesn't like anything with more than two legs. He's actually afraid of dogs.
Well, if we run into dogs, I can mind control them.
Good.
Well, they're your friend.
Right. Well, they're kind of automatically my friend, and then I can use a psychic power to make them more my friend. They will never target me unless I'm hostile towards them, Jeff. Like, a pack of wild dogs would attack everybody else, but not me.
Nice.
That sucks.
And then I can try to use Beast Friend to actually befriend them and take control of them and stuff like that.
So, thank you all for watching. We'll hopefully be playing some more Pathfinder on Monday, but we'll see how schedules go. And y'all take care and have a good night.
Yeah.
Bye.
As far as Monday goes, I'm almost.